Hey folks, Brian Kaplan here with the Bigger Better Biz community, and I've got a quick tech tip just for you. Stay tuned.
Hey everyone, I'm Jake Burns for the Bigger Better Biz channel. Hopefully you watch my other two videos on where to find the templates for Constant Contact and also how to create a Cyber Monday, Black Friday kind of sale. In this one, we're going to do a holiday card as well as a holiday promo. So it's going to be very similar to how we did the last video for Black Friday and Cyber Monday. I still have on my trusty lobster shirt here. Like I said in the first video, lobster is a big thing that my family does the night before Thanksgiving, so it always puts me in the holiday cheer. And anyway, so let's move forward and we're going to create a new campaign for Christmas. First thing we're going to do is click on Create and then select Email. And again, here we have two options. We could have chosen one of our normal templates, like one of the normal emails we send out throughout the year, and then update it with some custom graphics, which we're going to talk about later when we talk about Canva. Or we can come here, click on a new template, and then find the templates that were created by Constant Contact for the given holiday. I'm just going to do Christmas because it's simple. And let's see what we have here. We can pick one. Let's try something different. Let's try Christmas card and see what that brings. Maybe nothing different. Okay. All right, so here is a good one. Happy holidays. Much like the one we did for Black Friday, Constant Contact really is very good about pulling these together and making it super simple to update. So first thing I always like to do, I like to update the subject line to make sure that it is what we want and kind of sets the mood for the email. And I'm going to find a holiday emoji, so Christmas emoji. Like this one. Isn't that one kind of weird? I don't know what that's supposed to be. So we're going to find Christmas presents. And I'm going to pick up Christmas tree. And how about another present? There we go. Good to go. And the pre-header is fine and certainly can update it. So now let's get started on updating the email. In here, I would suggest, if you're using this template, that you use a picture of your family. So I found some photos. I'm going to upload those photos here, and we can use them for kind of everything. So let's see. And these are just samples. All right, so I'm going to pick this photo. Can adjust it so the photo is a little bit bigger, or the other thing you can do is actually edit the photo and crop it. And click export. I love that feature. I use that all the time to make all the images kind of the same size throughout an email. It's a really nice feature. All right, so then you just update the text, make it specific to your business or what you're looking to get across. And then, you know, something, read more, I probably wouldn't do that. I would say maybe click here to see a Christmas card, click here to learn more about something, click here, or just even remove, you know, this if you're just saying happy holidays. Or say, you know, visit our website, something like that. Something very simple. This isn't really a sales email. It's just a basic happy holidays email, so I try not to be too salesy. And then down below, you can... I think these are two great ideas. You know, coming up with something for your customers, something that's a little more fun, maybe in line with the business, or maybe something just kind of free giveaways, things that they can use. So in this case, they already have it pre-done. So you can have holiday cookies, and then you would go and find maybe an article on best holiday cookies. Cookies recipe. And I'm sure there's tons of them. So you can use this link. You can certainly change out the photo if you want to. Just for time, I'm just going to pull in what we have here. And I would change this call to action to get the recipe. I can stay on it. Right? All right. And then, of course, adjust the text. And then for this one, maybe like the best morning breakfast, since there's eggs there, right? So let's say, and same thing, we're just going to link this out. And of course, adjust the text here as well to match. Update the company name and website, and then make sure that the social is going to the correct place. And that's it. So this is if you want to use one of their pre-made templates. I don't suggest going and adding all kinds of extra sections. Just keep it simple. You know, make it easy on yourself. This is really just having another touch point with your customers, making sure they know that they're respected and you appreciate them. Just to get something else out there so that they remember your name too, even if they're not a customer, maybe they're just a potential lead. So that's a nice, easy way to do that. So I'm going to save this, and you can would send that right away, or send it when you're ready. The other way is if, let's say you already have a template. I'm just going to pull the template we did for Black Friday, and I'm going to copy it and act like it's our normal email for our business. In this case, what I would do is, I'm just going to name this Holiday 2. All right, so in this case, and this is going to be a little more interesting, I think. So we have our logo at the top, which is great. And then for this one, we had a Black Friday promo. So in this case, I just want to send a holiday card. Just something nice and simple that says, hey, happy holidays from us to you. And I'm going to choose this one. It looks nice. You know, I don't even have to update this. This looks great, right? This looks really good. Certainly can update this if you want to. And what I would say is add a subheading in here, you know, from Brian Kaplan Marketing. Increase that size a little bit. Maybe bold Brian Kaplan. Make sure it's centered, and then let's download it. That was really, really easy. Certainly you can go and do as much there as you want to make it interesting. In the last video I mentioned I always like doing JPEGs for downloads here because I think it just works better, and I think they're a little bit smaller file size, so I suggest that. It doesn't take but a second to download, and then we are going to update this. Now in here, something that might be interesting for us would be, hey, check out our events, right? So check out our events in the new year. So I'm going to get the events link. And I'm going to change this call to action. And that could also be something like, you know, build your business in 2022 since we're doing marketing. I'm going to make it green just because it's interesting. And then, you know, update the text. Tell a story. In this case, I'm saying Merry Christmas to my clients or to, you know, to the potential leads that we have in our database. And for this, I would write something to the effect of, you know, thanks so much through thick and thin, you know, through COVID and everything else for maintaining being a client, for attending our events, and for, you know, obviously maintaining your own businesses. You know, we wish you a Merry Christmas and Happy New Year. Have it come from the heart. Don't just have it be something generic. Have it something that makes sense to your clients and that, you know, obviously they're going to respect and also think of. This is a nice touch point for you to reach out to your customers or your potential leads, obviously. So make it come from the heart. Don't just have it be an afterthought. It doesn't take long. You know, we built this email in just a couple of minutes, and it doesn't have to take very long. All right, so I'm going to update this subject line as well. And, of course, you can also do the emoji thing as well if you want. Kantagatik has some already in here. I'm not seeing any particularly great ones for Christmas. Maybe, like, candy canes or something. But, you know, we just searched and we did the lookup for Christmas emojis. So you can certainly go back and look at that. Just type it into Google, Christmas emojis, and you'll get a bunch. That's kind of a boring pre-header, but you get the idea that you're going to want to update it and make sure it's very specific to your clients. You're going to save that, and then this is going to be ready to send out. Okay? All right, so let's redo this now, and this time it's going to be for a holiday sale. So let's get rid of this, and now we're going to go look for a quick sale. Lots of options. And again, keep it very simple. So this already has up to 50% off. So if that's the promo you want to do, then this is like already done. How great is that? You come here and you find a button. Let's see if we have anything good. These are kind of okay, right? Nothing totally amazing. So let's type in button instead and see what that gives us. All right. Well, that's green at least, right? Okay, so get this thing centered. Nice little line there. And then I'm going to add some text to it. Shop now. No, didn't do anything. All right, so let's get rid of that. And I'm just going to put a header in here. That would be fine as is. I actually like to add some effects sometimes on these. So I'll do this lift. You see where it adds just a little bit of shadow there? I like that. I think it makes it pop a little more. So all right, I'm going to download this, and I'm going to download it as a JPEG again, as we talked about. And as you probably know, you can go as crazy as you want on these things and keep adding some more products and everything else. I'm just going to keep this simple just for this premise, you know, for the video. But I'll show you real quickly how then you can add some products to this as well. It's one of my favorite types of emails where you have kind of a main promo. Then you update the text here to be something about whatever the promo is. And then you say shop now as well. And then below that, I'm going to add another line here. Just do a separate. And then down here, I would add this nice double wide block. I don't usually like having the text here, so it really depends on the company and the brand, but I'm going to get rid of that. I'm going to add a button under each one. And let's change the button color to what we've been doing. Just for this purpose, I'm going to go to events, but normally, obviously, it would go to your product. One thing I'll say too is if you're adding individual products, a lot of times I like to keep off the price of the products because the price I've found through doing hundreds of these emails, when you add the price, a lot of times you get less clicks. When you don't have the price, people are like, oh, I like that, but they want to know the price. So they click on it if for no other reason to see the price. Now maybe they buy, maybe they don't, but the point is when they click, they go back to the website. Maybe they'll see something else. It's kind of like, you know, when you go to a shop, to a food store, and you have to go all the way to the back of the store to get your milk. Same concept. You know you need to go to the back of the store to get the milk, but they're giving you an opportunity to buy other things along the way, too. So same thing here. And I'm just going to add some pictures here. Now, you're not buying Brian, but, you know, I guess you could if you wanted to. We can ask him next time. But normally you put the product in here. I'm just going to bring up some of his images just so we can drop something in there. There you go. Good to go. Certainly, you know, something else, you can add reviews in here. You can add another row, so you have maybe four products or six products. Six products and a top line sale always looks good. I love doing those kinds of emails. And then, of course, adjust the subject line as well to make sure that it follows along. Anyway, hope you got tons out of this. If you have any questions at all, feel free to reach out to us on our contact form or certainly email us, and we'd be happy to help you out. So. Thanks so much for watching the Bigger Better Biz channel. I am Jake Burns, and I'll see you next time.
So there you have it, another helpful tech tip from Bigger Better Biz. Now, in order to receive more tips, tricks, and best practices in your inbox, be sure to subscribe to this channel and also click on the bell. When you do, every time we put up a new video, you'll be notified in your inbox by YouTube. While you're at it, be sure to join our free marketing community. When I say free, I mean free. We created it at the beginning of COVID in response to help as many small business owners as we could. We're growing every day by leaps and bounds, and we'd love to have you as part of the community as well. We provide articles, resources, videos, even access to exclusive webinars with me so that you can grow that bigger, better small business I'm always talking about. There's a lot to learn and a lot to know. As long as you can set your mind to just doing one thing today, you'll get closer to your goal. So get out there and do something. See you next time.